हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ टीचर मीनल परेरा। इन टुडेस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट मेट्रोलॉजी। ओके, सो लेट्स फर्स्ट सी व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मेट्रोलॉजी। मेट्रोलॉजी इज द साइंस दैट स्टडीज द इंटर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एयर, natural cycles like oxygen cycle, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, geological movement of the earth like climate changes, earthquake, tsunami, volcano, and climate is called meteorology. Meteorology includes the study of storms, clouds, rainfall, thunder, lightning, etc. So basically, meteorology is a branch that deals with climate and climate related factor. Depending upon the study of such factors, weather forecasts are made. In the previous video, we have studied that making a weather forecast or a climate is not a simple process. It involves lot of things. Okay, so depending upon the study, the weather forecasts are made. And they are useful to common people like us, which we can plan, or based on the climate, we can plan our traveling or daily activities. Farmers, which can plan their agricultural activities. Fisheries, that is fishing. They will decide whether to go in a sea or no, depending upon the storm. Then aviation center. Aviation services means the aeroplane related services. So that also depends upon the cloud and weather, water transport, shipping business, and various other organization, because climate or weather is important for everything. Then coming to Indian Meteorological Department. The Indian Meteorological Department was founded by British in 1875 at Shimla. This is the building of that Shimla office. Its head office is at Pune and its regional offices are at Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Nagpur and Delhi. So almost all the major cities of India. Maps are prepared every day, which indicates the daily predictions about the weather. Such maps are prepared and published twice in every 24 hours, because climate or weather is a very unpredictable thing. So maybe before 12 hours, what is the weather or climate? Suddenly it will change after some time. So therefore, twice the maps are made in a day. In this institute, research goes on continuously on various aspects like instruments for climate reading, prediction about climate made use radar system, prediction about climate related to seismology. Seismology is a science that studies movements of the earth. Predictions regarding rainfall by satellite. Nowadays, you all know that we use artificial satellite to predict the weather and air pollution, etc. So, this department is continuously working on for the betterment of the people. It is making maps and weather forecast every time so that the people are safe. Then, the India Meteorological Department provides information regarding weather and climatic condition to other departments like aviation, shipping, agriculture, irrigation, marine oil exploration and production, etc. Okay, so very often you must have seen this kind of picture on television or on computer. Okay, this basically gives you the idea. Now this is basically showing the temperature or weather. Okay, so the shining cities here, they show maybe that time it is cloudy and it is going to rain very heavily here. Okay, so like this maps are made, and then the various departments like aviation and shipping depends, or which mainly works on the climatic factors, these predictions are very useful to them. Prediction regarding calamities like dust storm, sandstorm, heavy rainfall, hot and cold, tsunami are communicated to various departments through all type of mass communication media to all the citizens. Okay, so they give us the prediction, like we always get a warning notice from the department, like next 3 days it is going to rain very heavily, so don't go out. or there could be a sandstorm. So don't go out, or very heavy rainfall. So prepare and go. So accordingly, all this mass media, that is radio, television, keeps on giving information to us. For this purpose, India has launched several satellites equipped with high-class technology. Observations at several locations are doing excellent work in the analysis of the information received from those satellites. And we should be really thankful to this technology and satellite because it actually saves the life of many people. Now children, you must be thinking that not all the time the predictions are correct. Sometimes they say it is going to rain very heavily and it doesn't rain. But just imagine children, if the warning of say, suppose volcano or earthquake is given and we just don't take that warning very seriously, an earthquake happen, what will happen? So many people will lose their life. So therefore, though sometimes these predictions are not very accurate, still they help a people a lot. Then, the tradition of forecasting the monsoon season in India is older than 100 years. After the famine of 1877, H.F. Blandford, the founder of IMD, has made such a prediction for the first time, taking the snowfall in the Himalayas as a parameter for this prediction. Parameter means criteria. So snowfall at the Himalaya was taken as a parameter. In the decade of 1930s, then the director of IMD, Sir Gilbert Walker, had underlined the relationship between various worldwide climatic factors and Indian monsoon. And based on the available observation and previous recordings related to the relationship, he put forth a hypothesis regarding the nature of the monsoon. Okay, so this is not a work of 1 to 2 days, children. So from so many years, so many scientists are working on it. They are taking into consideration all the factors that is going to affect the Indian monsoon. Now, very often we hear the word like the winds are coming from south side, the winds are coming from west side, there is a high pressure belt somewhere. So all these factors affect the monsoon. So the relationship between these factors needs to be studied. Okay, so all these scientists or all these people had a great work in doing this. With the initiative of Dr. Vasantarao Goharikar, in the decade of 1990s, a monsoon model based upon 16 worldwide climatic parameters was developed. So in case of 1990, a monsoon model was developed. This model was in use from 1990 to 2002. So till recently we were using this monsoon model. But as I said that as these factors keeps on changing every time or very often, okay, the new models have to be studied. Okay, so we cannot stick to any old model, but new models has to be there. Okay, so based on that, some new models are now formed. The first is the mathematical model, which is also called as dynamic model. Now, as the name says, mathematical, that means it takes into consideration the mathematical data. So this takes into account estimates of current weather related events and ongoing physical interaction between them. Okay, so current weather related events like temperature, humidity, pressure. Okay, so now you know that it is measured in some number. Okay, so these all numbers are analyzed and then based on that a mathematical model is calculated. Data about current climatic parameter is mathematically analyzed with the help of Param supercomputer. Now this is one of the supercomputer in India, okay, and that helps to find the all or analyzed all these models. Various mathematical models based upon daily geographical events are developed by supercomputer technology. So here mathematical model where numbers are taken into consideration. Moving further to holistic model. Now let's first see what is the meaning of holistic. Holistic means things related to the idea that the whole is more than the sum of its parts. That means all parts are taken and it is put into a whole. In other words, The entity of something must be considered instead of just considering its part. Like, for example, our body is a whole, okay, and it is made up of various parts like hand, leg, nose, mouth. So together makes our body. So like this, various climatic factors are taken, like temperature, air pressure, rainfall, snow, and all these are put together in a holistic model. Okay, so here the prediction based upon many parameters which were used in other models and used in holistic way to give the monsoon prediction. Predictions are based upon those parameters used in other models which have the greatest effect on the monsoon. So mathematical model or the statistical model, so all these models consider parts, but holistic model consider all these parts together. Nowadays, predictions declared by IMD are collective outcome of various models. Okay. Now moving to statistical model. You all know statistic. Now we can see in the diagram, the annual average monsoon precipitation in India over 110 years. Okay, so average is taken. You know statistic. It is in the form of graphs and bars. In this model, current climatic observation in the region are compared with earlier parameters such as oceanic temperature, atmospheric pressure, and the nature of monsoon rainfall of several years, many years. This data is comparatively analyzed by statistical method and predictions are made about the monsoon in the present condition. Okay, so now here these are the number of years, 0, 5, 10 number of years, and this is the average rainfall in millimeter. Okay, so then based on this, see here, the rainfall was not much. Now here high, here low. So we can predict. Okay, in maths you do know the series 2, 4, 6 and the next number is 8. Okay, so like that predictions are made based on the parameters that are studied for many years. Presently, a new model are being developed at IITM, that is Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology. Work is in progress at two levels, namely designing a new model and developing a new technology. The main focus is on developing of the radar system and the satellite technology. Okay, so new models have been developed. And March 23rd is declared or is celebrated as World Meteorological Day. Okay, so here this day is specially designed to this. Okay, children, so we have studied about three models that are used in the meteorology system. But here, children, as I said, that you have to remember one thing. Forecasting weather is not very easy or not very simple. It depends upon various factors. Okay, so we cannot say always the predictions will be right only, but still it helps to save the life of many people. Okay, and the meteorological department or the meteorological models keeps on changing depending upon what are the parameters at that time. Okay, so we should not make fun, or this is not happening only. Okay, so it is not like that. It is the collective effect of all the parameters that has been studied for various years. Okay, so I hope you are clear about the meteorology and all the models that we have studied. Thank you very much. God bless you.